All right, so let's kind of go over how to create your subtools and kind of how to block out the main forms. So I can see, let's say this is our goal, okay? We have a character, a lot of different parts here. First thing I would do is I would start by sculpting the body, okay? And how would you sculpt the body? You could go to the, you know, maybe start with Z-spheres or start in Maya, start with Z-modeler, and then you can use kind of the step-by-step approach that we did with the character, with the anatomy going through. And I feel like you can kind of go in there and you can see that even though this is stylized, I feel like it still has kind of the, it still has the anatomy in mind, where I feel like we can kind of see hints of different areas and kind of the same approach to it. But you would start off by creating the body, okay? The body of the character, like we talked about before, kind of dressing a mannequin. And now once we have the body complete, then we can kind of go like this. I'm gonna go control, I'm gonna mask off. And like we did in the other lesson, I'm going to control alt and unmask where I don't want things. And maybe I'll just have it like, just kind of a shirt here like that. Again, control alt and control alt. And I feel like what's cool is we it's easy to make kind of like a ton of accessories or a ton of kind of like layers of stuff, on the character. And this is where we kind of were able to get creative with things before, okay, in other lessons. And I feel like this is one of the easier things to do. So I'm just gonna kind of, this is gonna be a little bit review here. So if I select this, now what I can do is, let's say if I was happy with that, I can come into geometry. And again, this is in tool, geometry. Then I can come down here, it's in subtool, come down here to extract, and then hit extract. And what that's gonna do, it's gonna kind of create a thickness, and I can see right there. I can also see that I accidentally got some on the arm here, so I'm gonna wanna make sure that I'm very careful when I'm masking. So I'm gonna control alt, paint on that. Okay, cool. Excellent. So now let me try that again. And a good idea would be to kind of get in here and look right here at the thickness. So if I click on that, if I like that thickness, I'm gonna click accept. If I don't, I'm gonna readjust it. And by the way, if I click, it's gonna undo it. So then I set my thickness and what I think it should be, hit extract, look at it. If I like it, I'm gonna click accept. Now, when I do that, this is gonna get all masked off. I'm gonna control drag on nothing to clear the mask. And now I have something, okay? If I wanna isolate it, I could hit solo and I can see it right here. Okay, that's cool. If you don't see the solo button, what I can do is I can go to transform solo right here. I think it's good to hit solo because I feel like, again, if I had extra stuff on the arm, I might capture that here and I don't want that. So, I'm gonna unsolo it. Now I feel like I don't want it to look so skin tight. So there's a couple things I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go to poly F and that's gonna see the wireframe. Okay, now if this was dynameshed or something, it might not be obviously very clean. So I'm gonna come down here, I'm gonna go to geometry, Z remesher, and I'm gonna turn off adapt, maybe hit half and hit Z remesh. I'm gonna notice the orange bar at the top, and when that gets all the way across, it's gonna be done Z remeshing. Okay, and maybe I'll do it again, Z remesh. Okay, again, Z remesh. And I feel like, how do you know how many times to do it? I feel like until it looks like it makes sense, like it's nice and clean and organized. That might take a little bit of practice. I feel like this is still looking really dense to me, and I feel like it's starting to look better. But I want it to look like just kind of a nice grid. Okay, this is actually looking pretty good. Okay. Okay, that's pretty good, and I feel like I can see that. I'm gonna go to my move brush, and I'm gonna go ahead and press space bar, and I can kind of move that out. So don't worry about if the model kind of sticks through, because we can always adjust it. I can turn off polyframe here, and I can divide this up, and I can go maybe hold down shift around the edges, and then I might have to move. Okay. I can also do things like clay buildup. So if I go to clay buildup, I'm gonna go ahead and divide this up a little bit. And now I can make it feel like it's not so, again, quote unquote, skin tight. You'll notice that you could even see the belly button before, and now I feel like I can't see the belly button. Okay, divide this up. And depending on like how loose or tight the garment is, it's gonna be kind of dependent on, however you sculpt here. So I'm just gonna kind of add some, again, clay buildup. And I'm not gonna worry about like all natural wrinkles right now. Okay, I'm just kind of getting a garment. I'm gonna call it a garment that fits. And I'm gonna say, okay, hey, that's a good, that's a good accessory here. I like that. Now I'm gonna kind of move on. Okay, cool. Yeah, I like that. That looks good. And now I could create more. I'm going to call it accessories in here by masking. But let's not forget that if I wanted to, I could create accessories in Maya. And for example, if I come back here, I can see on this character, maybe this strap here would be easier to create in Maya using quad draw. Okay. Maybe these gloves were easier to make using quad draw. Okay. So what I could do is if I was going to make that strap in Maya, maybe I want to bring the shirt over, okay, into Maya and quad draw on that. So I'm going to maybe lower this to the lowest subdivision, and I'm going to click export. Then I'm going to go ahead and call this shirt, save it as an OBJ, and click save. Then I can go into Maya. And when I'm in Maya, I'm gonna go File, Import, Desktop. Here it is, Shirt. I'm gonna make sure that I don't move it. I can select it, press F. And now what I can do is I can come in here and go make it live. So I'm gonna click on the magnet up here. Then if I go to button one, go to quad draw, make sure that I have symmetry turned on, object X. Now if I click, hold down shift, now I can kind of start making this item here. Okay, so now I'm gonna kind of come down here. And I can see that I have the soft select on, but this colored area, so if I press B, I'm gonna get soft select turned off. Okay, so again, you might say, well, Dave, when do I use quad draw and when do I use extract? I feel like whatever you feel like is easier. I just feel like I have kind of more control using quad draw here. So I feel like maybe I'll use quad draw for this. And I feel like maybe I had more control, or it was faster, I should say, to make the shirt using just the extraction method. And so now again, I'm gonna call this, I'm creating all of my subtools. I'm not worried about detail. I'm just creating the subtool. Okay, I'm creating the everything that I'm going to need. Okay, now I can right click, go to object mode, select this, right click, go to face, maybe drag over all the faces, turn off the magnet, and then in the modeling menu set, I can go to Edit Mesh, Extrude, and then pull this straight up like that. Well, it looks like I didn't do all of that. That's all right. I mean, just enough to get the example going. Now, if I select this, I can go File. I can say Export Selection. And I'll call this, I don't know, Belt. Okay, Export Selection. Now, if I come back into ZBrush, okay, I can go like this, Subtool, and I'm going to Append. And I'll append the star. Then I can select the star. And then I can go to Import up here. And I'll select the belt. Okay, cool. And now I can see the belt, again, is in place. And obviously, I could do a lot of, you know, tweaking to get it, like, super nice and all this detail. But I feel like I don't care. Like, it's not about that right now. Again, it's about getting in all of the pants and the accessories and the, you know, what have you. Now, you might be saying, well, I've got a dragon that maybe doesn't have any accessories. And that's okay. I feel like I would work on kind of making sure the form is looking good. And, you know, if it has wings, like, do those wings look good? And is everything making sense? If it is, just keep kind of moving forward with it and continue to make progress with it. But again, I can see that I just started with a couple things here. And I would just kind of, again, keep this progress going, making stuff either in Maya or in ZBrush. And we also, you know, another way that we could do this, and this, well, we'll see. I could also append, and I could append, let's say, a cube here. And if I select this cube, I could then scale this down. And now I have an item here, okay? And now if I take this, I could scale this maybe smaller. So don't forget, you could make stuff directly in ZBrush, okay? Like these primitive shapes. If I do that though, if I come here, if I go to Geometry, as long as I can divide it, I'm good. That means that it's a true, you know, kind of a true real piece of geometry. If I couldn't divide it, I would have to make Polymesh 3D, but I feel like because I already kind of started the process, I should be good. So again, you can see like on my character here, like this piece here, okay, maybe that was easier to add in ZBrush. Again, it doesn't matter what, you know, if you're using Maya or ZBrush, you should be kind of going to this idea of going back and forth. And another thing too, like for the gloves, I feel like I kind of mask off and once I have the body selected. And by the way, you can press Alt, or I feel like it's Option, and you can click on these different things and you can see how it'll select your subtool. So what it's doing is over here, it's selecting the different subtools. So if you have a lot of subtools, that'll be easier to kind of navigate. You could, I guess, do this. Let's say if I had the body selected like this and then kind of do an extraction for the gloves. But I found that I had more control if I just kind of like did, again, quad draw in Maya. So again, do your best to just kind of continually enhance your character to the best of your ability, adding as much detail as you can. And remember, your goal is to show your understanding of ZBrush. So don't kind of sell yourself short, if you will. Try to have as much kind of that wow factor if you can. And but at the same time, don't add a lot of details, like intricate details at this point, because again, that might get lost during the retopology stage. Think about it as you just want all your subtools, you want anything that you are going to think you're going to need, but then kind of stop there. Then we'll talk about detailing next week. Okay, so hopefully that was helpful. Best of luck with the projects.